In this example, we are required to find the total magnetic energy stored in the annular region between two long coaxial hollow cylinders per unit length, which are carrying equal currents I in opposite direction, and the radii of the two cylinders are given as A and B. Now, in this situation, if we draw the physical situation, we can see if this is a hollow cylinder, which is having its radii A, and there is another outer hollow cylinder which is having its radii B, and the two are coaxial. It is given that inner cylinder is carrying a current I and outer is carrying a current I in opposite direction. So, between the two cylinders in the annular region, magnetic induction will only exist due to the inner current, as we already studied that when a current is carried by a hollow cylinder, it does not produce any magnetic induction in the interior region. So, from the central line at a distance x, if we find out the magnetic induction, we can write magnetic induction at a distance x from x is this magnetic induction, we can write directly as mu naught I by 2 pi x, as it is outside a hollow cylinder which carries a current I. And to find out the magnetic energy per unit length, that means we consider a unit length of this cylinder in which we are required to find the total energy stored. And the radius of inner cylinder is A and that of outer one is B. For this, at a distance x from cylindrical axis, we consider a hollow cylindrical element or elemental shell which is of width dx and radius x. It is like this. You just look at it very carefully. This is a cylindrical shell element which is of radius x and it is considered to be of width dx. And as the magnetic induction varies with x, we can assume that in this cylindrical shell, the value of magnetic induction can be considered to be a constant, as this width of shell dx is very small. Here also we can calculate the volume of elemental shell is, this can be written as dV, its surface area at the top we can write as 2 pi x dx and its length is 1. So, the volume is 2 pi x dx multiplied by 1. Now, we can directly write energy stored, field energy stored in elemental shell is this energy dU, we can write as the product of field energy density and the volume. So, this will be B square by 2 mu naught multiplied by the volume, which is 2 pi x dx. And here if we substitute the value of magnetic induction as mu naught I by 2 pi x, see what we'll be getting. This will be 2 pi x dx by 2 mu naught multiplied by B square, which is in this situation mu naught I by 2 pi x whole square. Now here if we further simplify this, here this 2 gets cancelled out. And on simplifying we are getting 1 mu naught also gets cancelled out. So this mu naught I square, and here you can see 1 pi gets cancelled out and 1 x also gets cancelled out. So this will be dx divided by 4 pi x. If this is the energy stored within the elemental shell, we can calculate the total energy in the annular region is integration of du. If we integrate the same expression of mu naught I square by 4 pi x dx, which is integrated from A to B, then see what we are getting here. In this situation, it will be mu naught I square by 4 pi is a constant. Integration of 1 by x will be ln x, and when we apply the limits, this will be ln of b by a. That will be the answer to this problem.